Vandegurum students, now see these two pictures. These two pictures represents.
Now I will explain you how to draw a clock. Okay, anyway, it's there in everyone house. There are so many shapes like square, rectangle, circle. So, but we are going to draw with a circular clock because it will be easy. So, take a big plate like your notebook page size, one page. So, I have taken like this, right? So, first of all, you have to draw a circle. So, you have to follow same like me, and your parents should not help because in online class I am going to check this. So, draw a big circle first. Next is, you have to write numbers, no? For that some rules are there. So, first thing, keep a center point like this. Okay. Next is, straight to that, here you have to write 12. This is the rule. 12, straight down, 6. You can keep scale also and check. It should be straight. And here 3, here 9. Okay. So, here 12, first midpoint, top 12, bottom 6, right side 3, now 9. Next is, you have to write the numbers from 1, 2, 3. But you have to maintain equal space. 1, 2, like this you have to maintain equal space. 10, 11, like this you have to write. So, can you see it's looking like a clock? If you are writing very, if you are drawing very tiny, it will be a watch, not a clock. So, you have to compulsory, you have to take a big plate. And you have to draw a circle and you have to fill this. Suppose if all the numbers are one side also, it's wrong. This is the rule. First, keep a midpoint. Top 12, down 6. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This side 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, I'm going to teach you how to draw clocks today itself. But I'll be teaching only one side, this side. So, in the next side, we'll be learning in the next class. In a clock, you can see two hands, right? One is short, one will be long. Parents, please show the real clock. One will be short and one will be long. Always you have to read the short hand first. The number which is showing. See, suppose the number here. This is short hand and this is long hand. Always first read the number shown by the short hand. Always you have to see the short hand first. So, 2. And the long hand is 12, means it is called as o'clock. So, what is the time now? 2 o'clock. Now, what is the time? 2 o'clock. So, what is the rule? First, you have to read the short hand. Then, you have to read the long hand. If long hand is in 12, you should say 2 o'clock. Parents, I know you will be very eager and you will start teaching everything. If you are teaching everything at a moment, really the child cannot grasp. Maybe now the child will say, but the child cannot remember. So, go in a slow pace. According to me, you can go. Now check out. This is the way we have to write the time. 1 O, here 1 apostrophe clock you should write. 1 o'clock. So what you are going to draw? 1 o'clock. So how to draw? First you have to start from center point only. The hand should not be here and all. Only from center point, and you have to use scale. So short hand should show 1, right? So, draw short hand towards 1. The long hand should be o'clock, means which number? 12. The long hand should be 12 like this. It should touch like this nearby, but it should not touch. The short hand should be little bit half only here. Halfway it will stop. 1 o'clock. Suppose if the short hand is showing 3, means it is 3 o'clock. If it is showing 4, 4 o'clock. If it is 5, 5 o'clock. If it is 6, 6 o'clock. But drawing, you need practice. So, you have to draw many clocks. Just you draw the clocks, this outline, these numbers. Then you will be getting the perfect clock. Now, what is the time? 4 o'clock. So, what you have to do? Yes, the short hand should show 4. So, your short hand you have to draw towards 4 and long hand towards 12. So, you have to draw like this. So, today I have given only few sums, 4, but you have to be thorough with that drawing of clock and the concept. So, the next class I will be teaching again also the clock only. So, please practice it, and even in your home also try to see the clock and identify the time.